another. There's an endless road to rediscover. Hey, sister, know the water's sweet, but blood is thicker. Oh, if the sky comes falling down for you, there's nothing in this world I wouldn't do. Hey, brother, do you still believe in one another? Hey, sister, do you still believe in love, I wonder?
Dearly beloved, we are gathered here today in the sight of God, family, and friends to unite this couple in holy matrimony. Marriage is God's first institution for the well-being of mankind. It is divine, distinctive, and a distinctive institution instituted by Almighty God and given to man in a state of innocence and happiness. The Bible records the first marriage in Mark 10:6. But from the beginning of creation, God made them male and female, and for this cause shall a man leave his father and mother and cleave to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. So then they are no longer two, but one flesh. God gives specific directions and regulations for the government of marriage. Love suffers long and is kind. Love does not envy. Love is not puffed up. Love is not easily provoked. Thinks no evil. Rejoices in truth. Bears all things. Believes all things. Endures all things. Love never fails. Join me as we pray. Father God, we thank you for your provision that brings hearts together in this bond of love. Grant the ties of this covenant that this man and this woman united as one may grow stronger with each passing year. May they trust each other with perfect confidence and together trust in your guidance for help in the path that lies before them. Extend grace and favor to them that they may prosper in the things of life, but especially, Lord, let them find favor in your sight so as they walk hand in hand with you all the days of their life, and through faith in Christ Jesus, enter into your eternal and everlasting kingdom. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Who gives this woman to this man?
Her mother and I.
If with trust in each other, you are now ready to accept each other as husband and wife to pursue life's journeys together, you will acknowledge this decision by taking each other by the hand, which you have done. Amen. Lyle, repeat after me. Do you, Lyle, take Anna, whom you hold by the hand, to be your lawful wife, to love and to cherish her, in joy and pain, in sickness or in death, forsaking all others, to cleave to her only so long as you both shall live?
I do.
Anna, do you take Lyle, whom you hold by the hand, to be your lawful husband, to love, honor, and cherish him, in joy or in pain, in sickness or in health, forsaking all others, to cleave to him only so long as you both shall live?
I do.
By the authority given to me as a minister of Jesus Christ in the state of Florida, I pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss your bride. I present to you Mr. and Mrs. Lyle and Anna Rose.
Today, we're here to celebrate a new beginning for Anna and Lyle.
Anna, you've always been unfailingly loyal and a truly wonderful person. I don't know how we could have gotten through the ups and downs. The ups and downs in our life without you.
Lyle, we have some advice for you. Clothing will explode from every bedroom, every nook and cranny. Yes. Like, literally, you will have no closet space. But it's okay because me and Kate can go over and borrow clothes, though.
We wish you many years of love and happiness, arguments and makeups, and more wonderful memories to make.
To Anna, love.
The end.
He loves hunting and fishing more than anything in the world, I tell you. But nothing compares to you. So, congratulations and best of luck.
Well, Lyle knows out of all people, when him and Anna started dating, I was not fond of it at all. It was just hard to accept the fact that my best friend is dating my cousin. So after a few years, I finally accepted the fact that they were in love, that they were going to get married. It was, congratulations, guys. I love you both. And wish you the best.
Yeah. Everybody, please raise your glass. You're gonna see it's our destiny. And give a toast to the new Mr. and Mrs. Lyle Rose.